When you're ready to move your business to the Microsoft Cloud, the first step is to sign up for a subscription that best matches the needs of your business. You can sign up for a plan now or choose a 30-day free trial to evaluate the service. Next, you'll want to specify the number of people you want to use the apps and services in your subscription. Then, enter your existing email address, and Microsoft will check to see if you already have a Microsoft 365 business account. If you need to create a new business account, type in your name and contact details, do a quick security check to verify it's you, then enter a username and domain name. Initially, this domain name includes your business name, followed by onmicrosoft.com. You can replace this with your own domain name later. To finish up, specify a password and add your payment method and details, which is required whether you choose a free trial or a paid subscription. Make sure you copy, save, or print your username, as you will use this to sign into Microsoft 365. Now that you have a business subscription, sign in with the new username and password you just created, and you'll be taken to the Microsoft 365 Admin Center, where you can start setting things up for your business. First, install Microsoft apps like Word, Excel, and Teams on your computer. Your users will have the chance to do this later. The next step is to add a custom domain name so that your email and sign-in address will look more professional and will be easier to remember. To do this, you'll need to prove that you own the domain name you want to use by going to your domain registrar and updating your domain's DNS settings with values you'll copy from Microsoft. Next, add information for each of your users or employees at your business. The last step is to connect your domain name to Microsoft email services so that you can send and receive email using your custom domain name. You may want to perform this step after hours, as this will disrupt email for anyone who's currently using your domain name. Similar to before, go to your domain registrar and update your domain's DNS settings with values you'll copy from Microsoft. Then return to the Admin Center to finish. You've now successfully signed up for and set up Microsoft 365. At this point, you can start using your subscription, migrating your email and files, or begin administering the service for your business.